In a stark contrast to the more muted official response, China state media on Friday lashed out at Rex Tillerson, Donald Trump's nominee for the U.S. Secretary of State, and warned of potential wars after Tillerson suggested a more aggressive strategy towards Beijing in the contested waters of the South China Sea. Now, in his Senate confirmation hearing on Wednesday, Tillerson said China should stop building artificial islands in the waters immediately, and its access to these islands already built should be denied. On Friday, the Global Times, a state-run newspaper known for its nationalistic stance, came out to say that unless Washington plans to wage a large-scale war in the South China Sea, any other approaches to prevent Chinese access to the islands will be foolish. It added that Tillerson had better bone up on nuclear power strategies if he wants to force a big nuclear power to withdraw from its own territories. Now, other official media outlets weighing as well, with the China Daily newspaper calling Tillerson's remarks naive, short-sighted, as well as full of prejudices and fantasies. Now, in contrast, when I asked the Chinese Foreign Ministry about these comments on Thursday, a spokesman simply said that things have been cooling down in the region, and it hopes the U.S. will respect the consensus China has reached with other countries on this issue. But South China Sea is now the only hot-button military issue between Washington and Beijing right now. On Thursday, China and Russia also came out to say that they have agreed to take further countermeasures in response to the U.S.-South Korean decision to deploy the THAAD missile defense system in South Korea. Now, Washington has insisted this is aimed at preventing North Korea from shooting missiles into South Korea. But both Beijing and Moscow have long opposed this move, calling it a security threat to their own interests. When I asked the foreign ministry about this announcement, a spokesman said, given the legitimate security concerns China and other countries have, it is entirely understandable for them to take further steps. So a week before Donald Trump takes office, an increasingly uncertain and complicated global security landscape, especially involving Beijing and Washington, seems to be awaiting the next U.S. president. Stephen Jiang, CNN, Beijing.